हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डीएफसी सेल एग्जाम प्रिपरेशन क्रैश कोर्स फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑपरेशंस एंड बीडी। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर हैविंग पार्ट 5 ऑफ योर इकोनॉमी एंड मार्केटिंग क्लास। ओके, टिल नाउ लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स वी डिस्कस। सो यस्टरडे ओनली, और सॉरी नॉट यस्टरडे, इन मॉर्निंग ओनली वी डिस्कस अबाउट एसेट्स। ओके, दैट इज नो व्हाट इज द एसेट, सम गुड्स और प्रोडक्ट दैट विल जनरेट कैश फॉर मी। ओके, सो कैश, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म, कैश। ओके, मनी। सो नाउ वी विल स्टोर दिस मनी into the safest place, that is your bank. Okay, not 99% it is safe, 1% there is probability. Okay, so in banks we will save the money, and yes, today's class will be all about your bank, all the history of banks, static data will be there. Okay, so make your notes properly about that. So let's start with this. So everyone knows what is bank. Okay, we deposit the money, we withdraw the money whenever we required. Some other facilities we are getting there, that is a locker facility. Okay, also we get loan, home loan, car loan, that loan, okay, all the loans we get there. Okay, then lots of other facilities, FD for investment perspective also, FD. Okay, then also it provides online banking facility, debit card, credit card, lots of things are there. This is your bank, okay, safest place to store our money or to keep our money or to park our money, Whenever we require money, just we can debit the amount, whatever we required, okay. So this is the thing. Now very important thing about today's morning class, that let me see whether you are getting the concept of asset and liability. Okay, so for that two questions will be there. Okay, and you have to comment the answers of those two questions. Okay, so first question will be this, that what is primary liabilities of bank. Okay, loan, money exchange, deposit, none of this. And second question will be, what is primary assets of bank? Okay, loan, money exchange, deposit, and none of this. So I want these two answers in comment section. Those who will get, okay, let's meet, see that whether you are getting the concepts or not, very important. And this question also you will get. So like this, they can frame questions. So if you have your concept in your hand, then definitely you can answer this. Okay, so let me see whether you are getting or not. If there is any problem, then in the next class I will deal with it. Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, now let's move to history of banks. So first bank in India, okay, is established in 1770. Yes, but it is not successful actually. Okay, it is not successful, and it is developed by Alexander and company. Okay, the name was Bank of Hindustan. What? Bank of Hindustan. Okay, Bank of Hindustan. Now then after 640 and 43, okay, like this I remember, 1806, 1840 and 1843. Okay, three banks was there. From this they decided to make three other banks. So Bank of Bengal. Okay, how to remember? BBM. Okay, 06, 40 and 43, Bank of BBM, Bank of Bengal, Bank of Bombay, B for Bombay, and M is Bank of, obviously, Madras, Bank of Madras. Okay, three banks was there now. Okay, so what happened next, that in 1921 they combine all these three banks and make only one bank named Imperial Bank. Okay, and in 1955 the Imperial Bank name gets changed and it becomes State Bank of India, which is our famous bank. Okay, about SBI, State Bank of India. So in 1955 we got State Bank of India. So this is how SBI formed. Okay, biggest commercial bank in India, of India. What do you mean commercial? Means the bank which provide basic facility like saving account, your deposit facility, your loan facility, like this, all those things I discussed already. Okay, next, the third question is that which of this is first truly Indian bank. Okay, they may ask you. So first truly Indian bank is Punjab National Bank. Okay, now on what basis I am talking, because this bank is formed by Indian only. Okay, so Lala Lajpat Rai and Dayal Singh was there. Okay, Dayal Singh was there. So these two people develop or just format do formation of Punjab National Bank. Okay, these two people. So just remember, first truly Indian bank was Punjab National Bank. Okay, so this is the data you need to remember. Okay, static data you need to remember. Okay, now lots of banks are there in the India. So one bank we require to control all the banks. Okay, so we then there is come 1935. Okay, 1st of April 1935 came and RBI is formed. Okay, RBI is formed, which will control all the banks throughout the country, whether it is commercial, whether it is commercial banks, whether it is corporate bank, any bank. Okay, any bank. So RBI, few points of RBI now. So you know that 1935. Okay, second point, the first governor of RBI, very important question, and the current governor of RBI. Okay, so first governor of RBI is Osborne Smith, and current governor is Shaktikant Das. Okay, what is the functions of RBI? Basically, see, our to control or regulate our economy. Okay, whatever the things are there, or whether we are going towards recession, okay, whether inflation is there, how to control, how to all those things will be regulated by RBI. Okay, then giving money to central and state governments, giving money to banks to have control on banks. That's why it is also called bank of banks. Okay, also it is called Central Bank of India. Okay, and foreign exchange also are there. Okay, foreign money we exchange there. Then minting, okay, currency minting making is there in RBI. So these are the primary functions of RBI. Okay, okay, next is your RRBs, regional rural bank. So this bank is basically in rural areas or in villages. Okay, they form the bank, and the primary role is to give wages, okay, pension to to old people, obviously, wages to Manrega workers, okay, then to provide money for small businesses, for basically it helps for rural development. Okay, the primary objective is rural development of RRBs, okay, regional rural bank. So these banks, 1975, okay, they formed 1975 RRBs, and now RRBs are in every state of India except Sikkim and Goa. So in Sikkim and Goa, no RRBs are there. Okay, so they can ask you the question, very important question, no RRBs are there in Sikkim and Goa. Okay, so just remember. Now next, SPMCIL. Okay, I hope that everyone know SPMCIL. Recruitment is going on already, and I hope you are preparing for that only. Those who applied already, 2 to 3 recruitments as there. Okay, so Security Printing and Minting Corporation of India. So what is the meaning of SPMCIL? Under SPMCIL, okay, it is the body basically under which we have these four, which functions. Okay, I will tell you one by one. So first discuss about year and headquarter. Yes, RBI headquarter I miss na. So it is Mumbai. Okay, RBI headquarter is in Mumbai. And just also one point I left, that financial year of RBI. So you know that for everyone of us, okay, we have financial year from your 31st of March to 1st of April. Okay, or I can say 1st of April to 31st of March. Okay, but for RBI, it start from 1st of July to 30 June. Okay, every year. This is the financial year of RBI. Also, they can ask you this question. Okay, so just remember this. Okay, let's come back to SPMCIL. So we are discussing about year and HQ. So year is 2006. Okay, year is 2006, and headquarters is in Delhi. Okay, now under SPMCIL, which is the body under Minister of Finance. Okay, who is Finance Minister? Nirmala Sitharaman. Okay, so we have four means. Under SPMCIL, we have four means. What are the name of four means? Just you have to write now very carefully. First, Mumbai Mint. Second, Calcutta Mint. Okay. Third is Hyderabad. And fourth is Noida. okay, Noida Mint. Now, if you observe your coin, any coin, okay, there are four mint marks. Majorly, these four mint marks are there. Some mint marks are also there, like foreign mint marks, okay. But majorly, these four are there, okay. So, you should know that by what symbol, okay, or what we can say, symbol, okay, what symbol they represent this. So, for Mumbai, you may see diamond, okay. Suppose in 1 year is there, 2008 or 2018, you can see, okay, diamond in below that, okay. So just observe any one of the coin, you will get this mark. So just consider that this is your Bombay mint, okay. For Calcutta mint there is no mint mark, okay, blank, there is no mint mark. For Hyderabad there is star and for Noida there is dot, like this, okay. So whenever you will get dot, yeah, then just consider that coin is minted by Noida mint, okay. So this four mints we have under SPMCIL. Then two note printing presses we have, okay. Note printing presses we have, how many? That also two. So first is in Nashik, Maharashtra, where? Nashik, Maharashtra, MH, and second is in Devas, MP, Madhya Pradesh, okay. We have two note printing presses. Now as per the name, it prints notes, currency, okay. Then we have two security printing presses, okay, at Hyderabad and Nashik, Maharashtra, okay. At Hyderabad and Nashik, Maharashtra, we have two security printing presses. Basically, here we print passport, visa, postal cards, postcards, that also we printed here, okay. Lots of things are there, like this means we are printed here, okay. In means we print coins, medals, like that, okay. Silver medal, gold medal, we print there in mint. And one last security paper mill we have in Hoshangabad. Where? Hoshangabad. Okay, Hyderabad. Again, Hoshangabad, Hyderabad. So here for currency we require paper, right? So that paper is generated or it is produced here in this mill. Okay. So this much information is enough for you. Now let's come back to NABARD. Okay. NABARD. So NABARD is established in 1982, okay. Headquarter is Mumbai. Basically what NABARD do, NABARD provide credit or loan, okay, to the small scale businesses for the agricultural purpose, okay. The main important role is to provide loan for agriculture development only, okay. Agriculture development promotion, like that, and also for rural development it work, okay. Earlier that loan providing facility was with RBI, but now all the things are with NABARD only, okay. So 1982, HQ is Mumbai, that is enough, okay. So this much information, static information, you have to write in your note. Now if any other information is left, then definitely I will cover that in our GK class, okay. So for now we will stop with this. So have a good night's sleep, and tomorrow very important lecture on this monetary policies will be there, okay. So just advanced version of banks. Now we will go again little deep in the banks and we will see what are the things are there which we should know, okay, to study economy. So till then, just make your proper notes, like the video compulsory, and again just what you can do, stay relaxed and have a good night's sleep. All the best.